Good morning, everyone. This is a lecture on mechanical variation. It is about free variation of spring pulley mass system using energy method. So in today's lesson, we can see various spring mass pulley system. So the basic objective of this lesson to analyze variation of mechanical system consisting of a spring mass pulley to derive equations of motion of spring pulley mass system and to determine the natural frequency of the system or to determine the frequency of the system. So for this reason, we will directly start with some mechanical system which consists of spring mass and pulley system. Let's see those system. Okay, let's consider the following pulley system. A block of mass M is connected to the translating spring with stiffness K through a cable which passes by a pulley, and the pulley rotates about a fixed mass center O. The moment of inertia of the pulley about its mass center is I naught, or we can simply take I, capital I, derive the equation of motion of the system and determine the equation of motion using the energy meter. So this is the question. So based on this question, so this is the mechanical system. Okay, so we can see there is a spring with stiffness K. There is a pulley with radius R, which is fixed at center O and having a moment of inertia I, and which is the mass is attached by cable. So mass is here. So what is, how we can drive the equation of motion, how we can determine the natural frequency of this system? That is the question. So from the law of conservation of energy, the total mechanical energy is constant. That means total mechanical energy is equals to kinetic energy plus potential energy, which is constant. So based on that, so mechanical energy is equal to kinetic energy plus potential energy. And the kinetic energy of the block of mass M is given as half mx squared. But in this spring pulley system, that x dot is the velocity, translational velocity. So that translational velocity is related with the rotational velocity of. So this x is equal to r theta of the pulley. The motion advanced due to the rolling of or rotating of the pulley is related with the translational motion of the mass x, so which is equals to x is equal to r theta. So the derivative of x gives us x dot, which is equal to r theta dot. So we substitute this r theta dot in the x dot square, so which gives us r square theta dot square. Therefore, the kinetic energy is half mr square theta dot square, so that is the kinetic energy of the block of mass. And the kinetic energy of the pulley with mass moment of inertia I is given by relation K of the pulley, which is equal to half I omega square. Omega means theta dot, which is half I theta dot square. So the potential energy of spring again, so whenever mass is applied in the direction away to in the spring system, then there is a potential energy of spring, so which is equal to half kx squared. So from that relation, potential energy of spring is equal to half kx squared, and this x is related with r and theta here. X is equal to r theta, so half k r squared theta squared. So from the law of conservation of mechanical energy, potential energy plus kinetic energy is equal to constant. So which is equal to this equation or equation with the star. Okay, this is the kinetic energy of the mass. This is the kinetic energy of the pulley. This is the potential energy of the spring. So which is equal to constant. Now, differentiating equation x with respect to time, we have dE, dt is equal to zero, which implies dE, differentiation with respect to time for the whole system, which is equal to zero. So that gives us half mR squared, two theta theta dot dot, plus half I squared, I two times theta dot dot plus half kr squared two theta dot, which is equal to zero. From this, what we can get, this theta dot is common for all these equations, so that theta dot will get out, and all this 1/2 r cancelled by two, so we can get this equation. Further, which gives us this theta dot dot having the two constant mR squared and I are having the same theta dot. That means rotational acceleration. So mR squared plus I the whole theta dot dot plus kr squared theta is equal to zero. So this implies the equation of motion. So this is directly the equation of motion for this system. Or simplifying this equation, we can get theta dot dot plus kr squared mr squared plus I theta is equal to zero. So this kr squared mr squared plus I, kr squared over mr squared plus I implies the natural frequency square. So from this relation, from this equation, we can get the natural frequency, which is equal to omega n squared is equal to kr squared divided by mr squared plus I. That means omega n is equal to kr squared over mr squared plus I. And where this I is the mass moment of inertia, which is related with the mass, means the mass of pulley. The capital M represents the mass of pulley. R actually is a small r, not capital R, because our pulley is having only a small r. There is no difference. So that half M small r square, this is I. So we can substitute this and we can get the natural frequency. This is the first question. And to more elaborate the type of questions, let us take this type of problem. Write the equation of motion and find the frequency in hertz of the system. Again, so we can write, this is almost the same question as the previous. It is almost the same. So as we see, this is the system of equation, and it consists of mass m. Mass is accelerating in this direction, and the pulley is fixed at this position with mass capital M and radius r. So, and the spring with k is connected with the rod or the rope here. So we can take this free body diagram. So as this pulley rotates at theta amount, as the pulley rotates theta amount, the mass will develop a distance r theta. X is equal to r theta. That is the relation between rotational and the translational motion. So the translational motion x is equals to r theta. That is so. And here we can take the free body diagram at this point. Okay, so that means theta amount means in the translation it is r theta. And the spring force F is equal to kx. And x is equal to r theta, so that k r theta is the spring force. Okay, here mass m, the acceleration of mass m is mx dot dot. So mx dot dot means we can make successive differentiation for x, then we can get r theta dot dot. So m times r theta dot dot. So that is the acceleration. Okay, so this the spring mass pulley system. So how we can, from the law of, not law, sorry, this is from law, L-A-W, from the law of conservation of energy, the total mechanical energy is conserved. So ME is equals to KE plus PE, which is constant. So the linear kinetic energy of mass M is just, it is similar to the previous question. So I will go quickly. Okay, nothing different. Okay, this is kinetic energy of the mass of with block of mass. And the rotational kinetic energy of pulley with moment of inertia I is the same thing. Kinetic energy of rotational kinetic energy is equal to half I omega square. So the potential energy of spring with stiffness K is half KR square theta square, similar. The total energy is the sum of the two, the system. So it gives this equation. Okay. So differentiating the energy, the total energy with respect to time, we can get the equation of motion. Okay, so the equation of motion is, this is the equation of motion. Okay. So from this second equation, what we can get, the natural frequency. This is the natural frequency in rad per second. Omega n here is given in rad per second. So which is equal to also, this we can rewrite substituting the I value, because I is equal to half m r square. So substituting half m r square instead of I, we can get k over m plus 0.5 m. So therefore, as we know, it is the natural frequency omega n, which is related to the frequency in hertz by 2 pi fn. So omega n is equal to 2 pi n f, means fn is equals to omega n over 2 pi. Therefore, we have this relation. Fn is equal to 1 over 2 pi radical k r square over m r square plus 1 hertz. Now it is in hertz, not in rad per second. Okay, so which is equivalent to is half 2 pi times k over m plus 0.5 m hertz, or someone can write it to k over 2m plus capital M. That is, capital M is the mass of pulley system. So this is what answer for the question. Again, another spring mass system. Okay, we have this spring mass system. This is also the same as the previous, but let's see in another method. Okay, so, so mass m is here. It is experiencing a distance. Whenever accelerate in this direction, it will develop x distance, which is related with r theta. R theta is the motion, the rotation of theta angle in the pulley produces r theta in the mass translational motion. That is what we have. So at a static kilogram position, as the pulley rotates by theta naught, we have, by taking the moment about O, we have mgr is equal to kr squared theta naught. Here, kr theta and mg in the free body diagram, we can see. So as it moves theta, so mgr is equal to kr squared theta. Okay, so that is theta naught is a small deflection or a small rotation about O of the pulley. So which this theta naught is equal to mg over kr. Even we can, from this free body diagram, we can get this solution. When the mass m oscillates with amplitude x, the pulley rotates by theta and the strain develops tension t. The equation of motion becomes mass, for the mass, mx dot dot is equal to mg minus t, let it be equation B. And this implies t is equal to, the tension t is equal to mg, that means the gravitational pull of the mass mg minus mx dot dot, means the translational acceleration of the mass. Again, for the pulley, I theta dot dot is equal to TR minus, here this is TR minus KR squared plus times theta plus theta naught. Theta naught is a small rotation due to the vibration of the system. Okay, we have B and the C here. So theta naught and the theta, the T in are plugged into C, and finally we can get the equation, and also substituting x is equal to r theta, x dot is equal to r theta dot, and x dot dot is equal to r theta dot, we can get this relation. Okay, so instead of I, mr square over 2, okay, we are just taking this equation, equation C, and substituting these parameters on it. Okay, T is equal to mg over kr. So instead of T, we substitute mg over kr. So finally, this equation will be reduced. And we can get m over 2 plus m, mass of pulley, mass of the translational mass, m. So m over 2 plus m, the whole r square, theta dot dot plus kr square theta is equal to 0. This finally gives us m, capital M over 2 plus small m, theta dot dot plus k theta is equal to 0 equation. So which finally gives us k over 1 over 2 m plus m as a whole radical or square root of this thing. So this is the natural frequency of this system. Another practical question we can see from here. A block of mass m is equal to 4 kilograms is attached to a spring of spring constant K, which is equal to 32 Newton per meter, by a rope that hangs over a pulley of mass M, capital M is equal to 8 kg, that means pulley mass. If the system starts from rest with a spring and stretches, find the speed of the block after it fails 1 meter. Okay, so when the block fails 1 meter, what will be the speed of the block? So that is the question. So how we can solve this? Since the rim of the pulley moves at the same speed as the block, the speed of the block and the angular velocity of the pulley are related by V is equal to omega r. Means that is X dot is equal to theta r. This means S dot is equals to theta. Okay. Again, when the block fails by distance x, its potential energy decreases. That means delta u is equals to minus of mgx. So the potential energy of the spring increase, delta s is equals to half kx squared. That is for spring potential energy. Both the block and the pulley gains kinetic energy. Delta k is equal to half mx squared plus half I omega squared. So that is, you see, this is the advancement of mass from this position to this. That is considered 1 meter, okay. And this b means x squared, x dot, which is equal to omega r. Omega r means the pulley radius. Okay. So a small rotation on the theta rotation on the pulley produces r theta in the mass. That's what we call. So from the conservation of mechanical energy, we have kinetic and potential energy, which gives us the following relations. So half mx squared plus 1 over 2 I omega squared. This is due to the pulley. This is due to the mass. And half kx is, this is because of spring potential energy. And this is the mass potential energy due to the failing of mass. Mass failing down 1 meter means mgh. So this is just a rearrangement. So finally, what we can get is it is a simple rearrangement. Okay, half m. Okay, half m plus m over 2 x dot square plus half kx square minus mgx is equal to 0 is the equation. So we can substitute mass of block 4 kg, mass of pulley 8 kg, stiffness of the spring to 32 newton, and the failing of mass, that is x is equals to 1 meter. So when we substitute this, we can finally get velocity of this system. Okay, what it gives us, x squared is equal to 5.81. That means x is equal to 2.4 meter per second. That is the speed of a block when it fell to 1 meter from released from the initial. Means initial velocity is zero. Released from rest means initial velocity is zero. This is also the same work which is done by some other person. So all the steps are the same. I didn't add anything on this, just for the sake of briefing, so someone can see this. Okay, let me elaborate the picture. So the spring will develop, or this translational motion that developed because of a theta amount of rotation. For example, this is a reference position. And then if this pulley is rotated to theta angle, then the translational motion as a result of this rotation is x is equal to r theta. So now kinetic energy plus potential energy constant. Kinetic energy of the mass m is equals to half mv squared, means v is in the case dx over dt, which is x dot. And kinetic energy of the pulley, that means rotational kinetic energy of the pulley is equals to half I omega squared, means omega means theta dot. So half I theta dot squared. And then substituting those parameters like x is equal to r theta, that means x dot is equals to r theta dot. So we can get kinetic energy of the mass half m r squared theta dot squared. And kinetic energy of pulley is the same as explained here. And the potential energy of spring half kx squared, which is equal to half k r squared theta squared. So the sum is constant. And finally, we can get the total energy, which is equal to constant. And dE over dt gives, which is equal to zero. So from this, we can find mr squared plus I, the whole theta dot dot plus kr squared theta is equal to zero. So theta dot dot plus kr squared over mr squared plus I as a whole theta is equal to zero. So which is equal to theta dot dot plus omega n squared theta, which is equal to zero. So omega n is equal to kr squared over mr squared plus I. And I is equal to half mr squared. That is what. This is also similar works. But the difference here is the spring is connected in some smaller r radius r, and the mass is connected with capital R, bigger size of radius of the pulley. So the best example is this one. Look, in this, there is a smaller rim. Rim is here, and the pulley is here. So mass is attached on the pulley, and the spring is attached to rim. So the radius, small r and the capital R are there. So that is the difference. So this time, what you can do? Potential energy of the mass, the potential energy of the spring is related with smaller r. So we have x1. X1 is equal to r theta, small r theta. And which gives us half k r squared theta squared. So kinetic energy one means the kinetic energy of the pulley is related with half I omega squared. That means half I theta dot squared. So kinetic energy of the mass is half mv squared. That means half mr squared. Now in this case, x of the mass, x2, I can say here, x for this spring system, let it be x1, and for this one, x2. X2 is equal to capital R times theta. Okay, capital R times theta. But x1 is equal to small r times theta. So we substitute those things. Finally, what we can get is omega n is equals to k small r squared over m capital R squared plus I. And I is also related with capital R, okay? So I is equal to m r squared over two. So this is the relation. So this is also similar principle. Mass is now, in this case, mass is attached to smaller ring, and the spring is attached to the bigger pulley. That means the spring system is related by capital R, and the mass is related with small r. Okay, so that is the difference. So let the deflection of spring x is equal to r theta. The spring deflection is r theta. And the spring force is equal to kx, means this x, that means kr theta. The downward movement of mass m is related x1, Now this x and this x1 are different. Why? Because r theta and the small r theta. So the mass is small r theta. So the kinetic energy is half mx1 square plus half I theta dot dot square. That is kinetic energy. It is x dot, not x dot dot. And it is also theta dot, not theta dot dot. The potential energy is half kx squared. Okay, so just make this correction, x dot, theta dot. Okay, this is by mistake. So differentiating with respect to theta, okay, substitute all the equation and finally differentiate it with respect to theta. So d over d theta gives us half mr square theta dot square plus half I theta dot square plus one over kr square. Here r is capital, here r is small, so that is the difference. Theta square, which is equal to d over d theta for constant. So mr square theta dot theta dot dot plus I theta dot plus kr square theta dot is equal to zero. Finally, we get mr square plus I times theta dot dot plus kr square theta is equal to zero. This is second order homogeneous type of equation, okay? Second order homogeneous equation. So this is equation of motion, theta dot dot plus kr square over mr square plus I theta. So finally, theta dot dot plus omega n square theta is equal to zero. That is equation of motion. So omega n is equal to k capital R square over m small r square plus I under radical or square root of this. So this is all about today. Thank you for watching this. Okay, so you can give your own comment. If you are interested, just see it and show your feedback, please.